spoiled am I? Gourmet breakfasts at sea. The dog approves. And Morgan's working hard down in the galley.
Yeah. Who says you can't eat fancy when you're on sea?
Fancy.
Fancy. Almost said at anchor. I'm not used to staying at sea.
Well, that's kind of like being at anchor. It's just, it's calmer than being at anchor in Vancouver, anyway.
Oh my god. This, middle of the Pacific is better than anchoring in Vancouver. Weird.
We're currently right here. Still off the coast of Cape Flattery, heading southwest, very slowly right now, 1.6 knots.
Working our way up to the trees.
Yeah, we need some more wind. This is tedious when it's like this. Too slow, way too slow. This moment's brought to you by Deschutes Pacific Wonderland. We are not sponsored by Deschutes, I just like to drink their beer. So what's going on, Morgan?
We are picking up speed.
Yeah.
Yeah, making progress now. The winds were light for a bit there, but now they're pushing us, what, 5 knots?
We're doing 5.5 knots right now.
5.5 knots right now, so.
On probably about 8 or 9 knots of wind or so.
Kick ass. Yeah, and it's a sunny day.
It's gorgeous out there.
Sea state's great, and we saw the veils.
We saw the veils.
The veils were so cute.
Yeah, it's quite lovely. But I mean, this is the shit, having this pilot house.
Oh yeah, being here.
Sitting in here and just relaxing.
Dope as hell.
Sails are trimmed and away we go.
Now I just get to chill and somehow end up in California.
Yeah, as long as the conditions stay nice and chill.
Yeah.
Well. Oh, I think we got a great weather window. Other than yesterday, gale force winds leaving the Strait of Juan de Fuca was pretty much a nightmare.
That was quite the way to start a trip.
Oh
yeah.
My God.
So we had things break, I think, because of that, not because of the offshoring.
Yeah, run down the list of day one failures.
So what happened? Our port side deck floodlight totally came out of its screws, or the bolts are gone, and it was
the
just
rivets. They're rivets
hanging by its cables. So that was not fun. And then Josh noticed this morning that one of the sail tracks for the mainsail wasn't even, one of the cars wasn't even in the sail track because a whole part of this track just snapped off.
Yeah, it's like old enough that I guess it's disintegrated and enough of it chip came off that one of the sail cars could just sneak out through that hole.
So, not what you want if you're using said sail or anything, you know, strong. So, well.
Yeah, that's a little.
So we try to tighten that up so it mostly is in the track now, but can't really do much about that right now.
Yeah, it seems to be staying put for now anyway.
Yeah.
And we also had the clutch for the jib halyard
completely blow up. So while you were up there in the shit.
Yeah, I was up there trying to tighten up the halyard because we just installed this new sail, so when the wind was really on, and I mean like 30 knots of wind, the foot of that jib was like really loose. So I was up there winching it up, and then I go to lock the clutch and then take the line off the winch and it almost sucked my hand through that fucking clutch.
You were up there in two strong winds and I was not pleased, but you were there doing that,
So now our mast winch is occupied with just the jib halyard for now. Yeah, I think that was the bulk of it.
Those are things that broke.
I know you have a list going.
Yeah. We have some things that we realize that we need to do, like just to improve stuff.
Yeah, the furler, I took a bunch of wraps off because I didn't want the line binding up in it, but in a heavy loaded sail and reefing down with it with the roller furling, when the sail's wound up that tight, it actually sucks up all of the line. Like I used up all the line. There's just like maybe one wrap around the sail with the sheets.
Hmm.
So I want to put a couple more turns of line around the halyard or around the furler, so that if it's really heavy winds and we're reefing it up like that again, then I can wrap a couple wraps of sheet around the sail to keep it from unrolling accidentally.
So while we were sailing in 30 knot winds
and shit. Like, the camera doesn't do it justice.
No, it never does. No one can rough. Ever know.
Like, they weren't huge waves, but it was just so choppy and miserable.
We had it on the beam, that yeah, one right on whole the beam. Tack. Yeah. Exhausting.
Yeah.
But because we have our dinghy lashed to the foredeck, the sheets for the storm jib were actually getting caught on the dinghy as we were trying to tack.
Yeah.
And you had to keep going forward and undoing that, which was not very safe.
No, the whole bow was plunging into the waves, and I was routinely getting soaked. We just weren't prepared at all for that, like, for day one.
That wasn't supposed to be what happened that day.
No, we didn't see that in any forecasts. Mind you, we didn't listen to the marine forecast right before we left, which we should have, because they were talking about 30-knot winds in the western section of the Juan de Fuca, but... Anyway, we got through it with... Oh, yeah, I had to go up on deck in the middle of all that and retie the sheets on the jib.
That's right. You also redo the sheets.
Because they were running inside of the shrouds, and the sails were loading up on the shrouds, which I didn't want. So we ended up having to pull the starboard sheet across and let the sail roll out enough that I could get to the clue of the sail standing on top of the dinghy on deck. And then untie the port sheet, run it outside of the shroud, tie it back on. All meanwhile, the bow is just plunging through water in 30 knots of wind. And it was,
Yeah, for, you know, the first time actually using our jack lines and being in conditions like that, you went forward way more often than I would have
liked. Yeah, I was up forward a ton. And same with dicking around with our lazy jack lines, too. The lazy jacks for the catching the main when we dropped the mainsail. Those things were, like... way too tight with the sail reefed out, it bags way out, and then the jack line or lazy jack lines are like just binding up on the sail, and it was a whole bunch of tuning stuff that you don't want to deal with in 30 knots of wind.
No,
because they were brand new sails, so it's the first time we run sheets or reefing lines or lazy jacks or anything on all of this new sail. So
yeah, I haven't tried them out yet. So
that was an interesting experience, just trying to get everything honed in, but
yeah, that's how you find out what's working and what's not working, I guess.
Yeah, so we're tuned up now. I feel like we're probably good if we run into that kind of squally, gale-y weather again.
Yeah, I hope we don't.
Hopefully we don't, and we shouldn't with this weather window. It's pretty amazing. Yeah. Like, look at it offshore. It's just blue skies all the way to Hawaii, where there's a couple hurricanes going on right now, but we're not going that far.
Yeah.
Yeah. But this is why we bought a pilot house. This is way better than a Dodger.
That's amazing. You don't have to be outside the whole time. I take that for granted already, because I've never had to do that. So.
Oh yeah, you just pop up, do what you gotta do, throw an attack, whatever, and then come right back down, put on a kettle.
How cool.
Put on a spot of tea.
Yeah,
this is definitely easy to get used to.
You have tape and whatever you need. Yeah. Oh, my fuck. You hold on.
Yeah. Was such a good idea because we don't have any spare helios right now.
Right.
I mean, you could pull me up with this, but you know, you'd have to winch me up. It's probably faster than winching, actually.
It's a good backup. Oh! Oh, and you just dropped the tape in the ocean.
What? It? Oh, I did?
Yeah. Okay, come down. Now, how that fucking happened? Bonk, bonk, dunk. I'll go grab more and reach it up to you. So you had it in a pocket? Have you seen the whales? Glad I bought two of those things.
Yeah, I bought two more too.
Oh, good. No, fair enough. Is that scary?
I'm like so tired already.
Yeah. No, and after particularly going through that gale day getting out here, we were even more exhausted.
Oh yeah, we ran a marathon to get to this point.
Yeah, we didn't get to start fresh.
Why is she so angry? Guys, relax. Shush. What? Be quiet, pal. Hey. Easy does it. Hey, no barking. Kais doesn't like dolphins at all. They are ripping around here though, eh? She's losing her mind. Look at them. Oh, it's so cool. Kais hates dolphins. Relax, relax, buddy. It's okay. Boat family.
Hi. Did you see the dolphins?
I sure saw the dolphins.
I just wanted to tear their throats out by the
time. Yeah, she was like not having that. They're coming up around her house.
I had her by the hindquarters because she was about to go to the window.
You're a ridiculous dog.
Show those nasty dolphins.
You're so funny, Kai.
He's such a fat.
Oh.
ready.